I'm still using the textile design that I have on here. And then the hair becomes, this mask becomes the head for the priesthood. And these are things, sometimes they make these on totem poles, and the head are made out that way. So it's not something that I just made up. I looked at, did research, and I looked at the way the various tribes, and this shape of the mask and the type is related to lab. Now, if you're going to ask me what was that all about, what it meant, whatever, all I know that this is the type of mask they had in reference to this type of fish and turtle tail, and these types of wavering design and line. Now, some of them I embellished by putting additional things in there that may not bend. Like, this is part of my design.
Oh, okay.
All right? Because what I did, again, I painted all that green, and then I come back, I think I painted the green or yellow, one or the other. Then I come back and I lay my tape on, and then I repaint through that, and that gives me a nice strong lines and pattern.
Okay.
And so the designs and textile type design, but I form it so that it looks like a body
right.
Standing up.
Uh-huh.
Something
like a sling or an arm or something like that.
But it's really just flat, grabs a piece of wood. Now this mask is from Benin. Now this is where I took some liberties here, in a sense. Now they did this in lost white technique with copper. This is part of their design. But this head is Benin. In Africa, you had a lot of great cultures and civilization. Benin, Ife, Nuuk. They were considered to be pretty big, and they had some real modern, I mean, it is a fascinating looking artwork.
Now, you've gone to Africa?
Never.
Really?
Not in this life, really.
Oh.
All
right.
No, all this is research in terms of what I studied from the books and talking to his grandmother, Margaret Perot.
Okay. All right. Gosh, that's great.
And this is another part of the mask. It's the same thing. Anytime you see the mask, it's the same.